A very good day to all of you.
Computer Shiksha is supported by.
As you all know, you will be learning something new today. But before that, let us revise what we learnt in the previous class. Can you tell why we use font color? With font color, you can change the color of your text and numbers. Can you tell the difference between background color and font color? In spreadsheet, with the help of background color, you can change the color of the background of your text. With the help of font color, you can change the color of the font of your text and the numbers. Can you tell what is the shortcut command for bold? The shortcut command for bold is Ctrl plus B. Can you say what is the shortcut command for italics and why do we use italics? And by using italics, you can make your text and numbers appear tilted. The shortcut command for italics is Ctrl plus I. Can you tell how many types of alignments are there? Alignment can be of four types: left alignment, right alignment, center alignment, and justify alignment. Can you tell what is the shortcut command for center alignment? The shortcut command for center alignment is Ctrl plus E. All of you, now switch on your computers and open the CalC file using the method taught to you. Let us now see what you are going to learn today. First, you will make a table. You will now learn about the header and footer. Then, you will learn about some of the options of the view menu like normal, page break preview, toolbar, formula bar, status bar, column and row header, sidebar, and zoom. Then you will practice the formulas you learned in the previous class. Now, make the table being shown to you. You can make a table on your own also. Let us now begin learning about view menu. As you know, the view option helps you to show or hide an option. Let us first learn about the page break preview option. Can you tell why we use the page break preview? With page break preview, you can view your sheet till the place you have typed on it, even if you have given space in it. You can even type in it. Let us now learn more about the page break preview by watching the video. Let us see what happens with the page break preview option. So, for using the page break preview option, we take our pointer to the view menu of the menu bar and left click on it and then choose the page break preview. As soon as you click on this option with the left button on your mouse or touchpad, you see that the text which you had keyed in on the sheet will appear as page break preview. The other items of the sheet are not shown. So this is what happens with page break preview. Next, let us learn about the normal option. Do you know why we use the normal option? With the help of the normal option, you can view your sheet in the normal view, and you can view it as a single sheet. Let us now watch the video and learn about the normal and page break preview. Let us now see what happens with the normal option. So right now what you are seeing in the video is the page break preview view. So to get the normal view, to see the normal sheet, we want the normal view. So we need to bring our pointer to the view menu of the menu bar. Left click on this and you can see page break preview is selected here. So we now, since we need the normal view, we click on the normal option. As soon as you click on the normal option, you can see the normal view of the sheet. So you can see both sheet 1, sheet 2, sheet 3, all of them are available in this normal view. Whereas in the page break preview, you could only see it till you have typed. Let us now learn about the toolbar. Can you tell why we use the toolbar? With the help of the toolbar, you can hide and again show the toolbar. Watch the video to learn more about it. With the help of this video, we will now see how we can hide parts of the toolbar or the complete toolbar. So, to hide the toolbar, we will need to take our pointer to the view menu. Left click on that, bring your pointer to the toolbars option, and you see many options here. The ones which are selected are already shown on the sheet. So as soon as you click on the find toolbar, you see that the find toolbar gets hidden. Once again, if we take our pointer to the view menu of the menu bar, left click on that, bring a pointer to the toolbars option, and now this time let's click on the formatting toolbar. So as soon as we click on the formatting toolbar, you can see in the video that the formatting toolbar has also got hidden. It is no longer available on our sheet. Next, once again take the pointer to the view menu, bring it to toolbars option, and this time let's click on standard option. So you will see that as soon as we click on the standard option, the standard toolbar also gets hidden. Once again, if we take our pointer to view, click there, bring the pointer to toolbars. Now there is a formula bar which is visible. We click on that option and the formula bar also gets hidden. So this is how we can hide the parts of the toolbar. Now to show them again, we need to again bring the pointer to view of menu, click on toolbars, and now let's click on one of the options here to bring it back so that it is shown again. So we click on formatting option and you can see that the formatting toolbar appears back on top of our sheet. Once again, take the pointer to the view menu, left click, come to the toolbars option, and this time let's click on standard option. As soon as we click, this toolbar is not appearing. So just take your pointer to the formatting toolbar left side and then keeping pressed the mouse or the touchpad left button, just drag it a little up or down and you will see that the standard toolbar also gets shown. Next, take the pointer again to the view menu, click there and bring it to the toolbars option. This time let's select the formula bar. So once we select the formula bar, you see that the formula bar also appears on your sheet, or it is shown here. Once again, take the pointer to view, left click on that and bring the pointer to toolbars option. Now we have to click on the find option, so to bring back the find toolbar. So once you click there, you can see that the find toolbar also comes back. So this is how you can hide or show the toolbars on your sheet. Let us now learn about the formula bar. Can you tell why we use the formula bar? With the help of the formula bar, you can know about the formula you are using, and using the formula, you can make changes in the formula also. Let us now learn to hide and show the formula bar. We will now see how we can hide or show the formula bar. As you can see in the video, the formula bar is visible on top of your sheet. To hide this, take the pointer to the view menu, left click on that, and then you can click directly here on the formula bar option. As soon as you click, the formula bar gets hidden. Now if you want to show it back again on the sheet, you need to take the pointer to the view menu of the menu bar, left click on that, and then just click directly on the formula bar option and your formula bar will get shown. So this is how you can hide or show the formula bar. The next option is for value highlighting. Can you tell why we use value highlighting? Using value highlighting, you can highlight the numerical values on your sheet. Let us watch the video and learn more about value highlighting. This video helps us to understand how we can use the option of value highlighting. Value highlighting will highlight any data values that you have written on your sheet. So to use this option, you need to take your pointer to the view menu of the menu bar, left click on that, and then click on the value highlighting option. As soon as you click there, you will see that all the numbers that you have typed on your sheet get highlighted. The text is not highlighted. Now if we type some new text, it is not highlighted, but if we type numbers as is being shown in the video, they also appear with highlight. So now if we want to remove the highlighting, we will once again take the pointer to the view menu in the menu bar, left click on that, and once again click on value highlighting so that the value highlighting effect will go away and the numbers will appear as they were originally. Let us now learn about the sidebar. Do you know why the sidebar is used? The sidebar helps you to do your work more easily, like a shortcut. Whatever work you do on the sheet, you can see its options on the sidebar and you can make use of the same. Let us now learn how to hide and show the sidebar. This video will help us in seeing how we can hide and show the sidebar. In the video that you see, you can see on the right side there is a sidebar right now. So if you want to hide it, we need to take a pointer to the view menu in the menu bar, left click on that, and then look for the sidebar option, which is ticked here right now. So just click on it, and as soon as you click, the sidebar from your screen goes away or gets hidden. So now once again, if you want to bring back the sidebar to see the sidebar or show the sidebar, take the pointer to view, click there, and then click on the sidebar option. As soon as you click, the sidebar will reappear or will get shown. This is how you can hide or show the sidebar. Next, you will learn about the full screen. Can you tell what happens with the full screen? With the full screen option, you can view your active sheet in the large screen. The shortcut command for this is Ctrl plus Shift plus J. Let us watch the video and see how we use the full screen. In this video, we will see how we can see our spreadsheet in full screen. In order to see the spreadsheet in full screen, where all your text will be available in the entire screen without any of the formatting bars, etc., take your pointer to the view menu, left click on that, and then click on the full screen option, The shortcut command is Control plus Shift plus J. So you can see your spreadsheet now appears in the full screen, in the big screen. If you want to bring it back to the normal screen, you can just click on this full screen button or use the shortcut command Control plus Shift plus J. So this way you can view all your content of the spreadsheet in full screen. We're showing it again for practice. So this is how you will be using the full screen option on your spreadsheet. The next option is for the Zoom box. Do you know why we use Zoom? With the help of Zoom, you can increase or decrease the size of your active sheet. Let us now learn more about using Zoom with the help of the video. With the help of this video, we will now learn to use the Zoom option. Zoom can be used to increase the size of our sheet, what is visible, or decrease the size. This can be done in two ways. In the status bar, on the right bottom side, you can use the plus sign. If you click on plus, it will increase the size of the text and the letters that you can see. So it will zoom up. If you click on the left side where it is a minus sign, it will decrease the zoom size. So 100% is what you see normal. So right now we have just kept it at 100%. The other way of using Zoom option is from the view menu. Click on the view menu and then click on the Zoom option, which is right at the bottom. Once you click there, a box opens and this has options for fit, width and height. So whatever available width and height is there, it will fit there, or 100% or variable. If you click on variable, you can click on the up arrow to increase the zoom size. Click on the down arrow to decrease the zoom size. So you can increase or decrease. And then if you click on OK, that will get applied. If you click on 100%, 100% size will remain. So this is how you can zoom up or down using the status bar or the view menu option. Now, all of you practice the use of sum, multiply, subtract, and division. If you face a problem, watch the video. We will now practice the use of the addition or the sum formula and the division formula. As you can see in the video being shown, we have data on our sheet already. So, since we want to add the total of all sales, the car sales, bike sales, cycle sales, we bring our pointer to the F2 where we want to add these sales. Type in the formula, which is equal to sum, S-U-M, and then we select the data that we want to add. After putting the beginning of the bracket and then put the end of the bracket and press enter, and you get the total sales. Then, since you want to copy this, just drag the formula from this F2 cell downwards and you get the sales for all the items. Total sales for all the items for A, B, C, D, E, F. Now, since we want to practice division, we will just write division here. And in this cell, put the formula for division, which is equal to, and then we type the word quotient. So equal to, and then type from the keyboard the word quotient, Q-U-O-T-I-E-N-T. Then put the begin bracket, which is shifted 9, and then put the numerator or the number which you want to divide. So let's take the total of A, which is 48. Then put a semicolon, type it from the keyboard. Now we want to put the denominator or the number with which we want to divide. So in the A row, we take the car sales, which is the B2 cell, and close the bracket and then press enter, and we get the answer, which is 4 here, as is being shown in the video. So this way you can do the sum or the addition and the division. All of you will now learn about the formulas for average, max and min or minimum. Can you tell why the average formula is used? With the help of average formula, you can find out the average value of the given range of numbers. Let us understand with the help of the video being shown as to how the average formula is applied. With the help of this video, let us see how we can find the average of given numbers on our sheet. So as you can see, we have for A, we have car, bike, cycle sales. So we want the average of that. So let's first type in the formula for average. So we are typing equal to and then the word average, AVERAGE, then begin bracket with shift 9 and then select the numbers for car, bike and sales as is being shown in the video. Then close the bracket and press enter. And you will get the average for these three numbers. Now we can also use average in a different way because already we have the sum of all the sales. So here we will type equal to average, then begin bracket, which is shift and 9. And then we type the all sales number, the total sales number, which we already have here. And then put the slash or the divide sign from the keyboard and then select the number. Since it is, these are three that we have added, car, bike and cycle sales. So we just type 3 here, close the bracket and then press enter again. So we get our answer for the average of B row. Now since we already have a formula applied, we can just copy by dragging this formula from the B row to all the other rows downwards. So just click on the black dot. When the plus sign comes, drag it downwards and you will get the average for all the rows. So this is how you can use average in two ways. Can you tell why the maximum formula is used? With the help of max, you can find the maximum value for any given record. Let us now use the video being shown to us to understand how we can apply max. With the help of this video, let us now see how we apply the maximum formula on our sheet. So to apply maximum, we are going to find out the maximum in the maximum sales column. So in the G2 column, we have to type the maximum formula. So we are typing as is seen in the video, equal to, and then for maximum, you need to just type max, M-A-X, then begin bracket by pressing shift and the 9 key, and then select the numbers for which, amongst which you want to find the maximum. So since we want to find the maximum sales for the car, bike and cycles, so we select these three numbers for the A row, then close the bracket by pressing shift and 0 key and then press enter. So you will get the maximum between car, bike and cycle. As you can see, between 12, 16 and 20, the maximum is 20. So you've got 20 here. Now, if you want to copy for the other rows, just come back to G2 and drag it down. So, you get the maximum sales for each of these rows. You will now learn about using the minimum formula. Can you tell why we use the minimum formula? Using the minimum formula, you can find the minimum value of any record. Let us understand with the help of the video being shown to us how the minimum formula is applied. Let us now learn how we can use the minimum formula and how we can apply it on our sheet. So minimum will give you the minimum value. So first you take the pointer to the cell where you want the minimum value to be produced. So which is the H2 cell, type the minimum formula which is equal to, and then for minimum you just need to type MIN, then begin bracket with shift and the 9 key, and then select the numbers from amongst which you want the minimum value to be produced. So after doing this, close bracket by shift and 0 and then press enter, and you get the minimum value, which from car sales, bike sales and cycle sales, 12, 16 and 20 is 12. Now if you want, you can just copy this by dragging it down, and all the other rows will also get the minimum value shown. This is how you use the minimum value. Now all of you go ahead and show how you will convert your file to PDF. And then save your file and properly shut down your computer. In today's class, you learned about a few of the options of the view menu, like normal, page break preview, toolbar, column and row header, value highlighting and zoom. And then towards the end, you also learned about some of the formulas like sum, average, max and minimum.
Computer Shiksha is supported by.
Thank you.